dancing. It's really indulgent. My tenants in the boat. But Tom is little soldier. Hut, two, four, three.
Is a song modern miracle of calculus? Where such frequent miracles don't render each one a miraculous.
Sorry, Doctor. What am I thinking? This calls for a proper smoke. Oh my word,
he's an ugly little thing.
This is the most beautiful child I've ever seen.
Oh my good lord, where's his thingy?
His what?
His thingy, is that? Whatchamacallit, his dildo. What have you done with his thingy?
This child doesn't have a thingy because...
What? A boy with no thingy? What have you done, you stupid woman? The boy's got no thingy.
This child is a girl. A beautiful, beautiful little girl.
Is there still time for the biannual international sausage and amateur...
A dance competition's finished. You missed it. Now, I don't suppose we can exchange it for a boy now, could we?
This is the worst day of my life! Ow! My undercarriage doesn't feel quite normal. My skin looks just revolting in this foul fluorescent light. And this gown is nothing like the semi-formal, semi-Spanish gown.
Rich.
How rich?
Very rich. Russian. dashing businessman. Very, very stupid. Your genius husband is going to sell them 155 knackered old bangers as brand new luxury cars.
But that's not fair. The cars are broken down. What about the Russians?
Fair. Listen to the boy.
I'm a girl.
Fair does not get you anywhere, you thick-headed twit brain. All I can say is that Kevin's Michael has an head in his old man's brains. Hey, son.
Michael.
Well, I shall take the money when you earn it. And I shall spend it. But I shan't enjoy it because of the despicable way in which you have talked to me tonight.
This is your fault. With your stupid books and your stupid reading.
But I didn't do anything. That's not right.
Right. Right? I'll tell you something. You're off to school in a few days' time, and you won't be getting right there. Oh, no. I know your headmistress, Agatha Trunchbull, and I've told all about you and your smarty pants ideas. Great, big, strong, scary woman she is. Used to compete in the Olympics, throwing the hammer. Imagine what she's going to do to a horrible, squeaky, little goblin like you, boy.
I'm a girl.
Now get off to bed, you little bookworm. Come on.
Have to pronounce that.
assassins. Good hair means a good brain. Now, the secret to my success in business is secrets. Yes, secret. The secret to my success is this. Oil of violet hair tonic for men. Now, stand back, son. The old man's going to work. Oh, yeah. That's the stuff. Oh, yeah. That's where it's at, all right. That's the bananas right there. Let me tell you something, son. A man in business simply cannot fail to get noticed when he looks like this. Secrets. Woman, have you started already? It's not even 8:30. My hair's green!
What on earth did you do that for? Why do you want green hair?
I don't want green hair. I didn't do anything.
Maybe you used some of Mummy's peroxide by mistake. That's exactly what you did, you stupid man!
My hair! My lovely hair! Oh my good lord! I've got my deal today! The Russians! What am I going to do?
I know what you can do.
What? What is it? What can I do?
You could pretend you're an elf.
Yes, that's it. I can pretend I'm... What are you talking about, you fool? The boys have known it. Come on.
Mum, would you like to hear a story?
Don't be disgusting! Go on, creep into that library of yours or something. The sooner you're locked up in school, the better.
Patience.
madly slipping her hand into his. It is where the loneliness of life has led us.
I'm a miracle. My daddy says I'm his special.
Tully, and today is a very special day. Your first day at school. Now, do any of you know your two times tables?
Wonderful!
Matilda, isn't it? Please stand and do as much as you can.
1 times 2 is 2, 2 times 2 is 4, 3 times 2 is 6, 4 times 2 is 8, 5 times 2 is 10, 6 times 2 is 12, 7 times 2 is 14, 8 times 2 is 16, 9 times 2 is 18, 10 times 2 is 20.
Oh my word, that's
22, 12 times 2 is 24, 13 times 2 is 26, 14 times 2 is 28, 15 times 2 is 30, 16 times 2 is 32.
Stop! Stop! Good heavens! How far can you go?
I don't know. Quite a long way, I think.
Do you think you could tell me what 2 times 28 is?
56.
Well, yes. How about this?
Now, this is much harder, so don't worry if you don't get it. But 2 times 487. If you took your time... 974.
12 sevens.
84.
Oh, my goodness! Now, children, let's leave math for the time being and take a look at reading. Can any of you tell me what this reads?
Oh, yes. Hey, baby, it's Jimmy, Jimmy,
very well, Nigel. Yes, I think we'd better leave it for there, Nigel. We wouldn't want you to burst a blood vessel on your first day.
Without Wormwood motives. excellent man told me to watch out for the brat, though. Said she's a real wart.
Oh no, Miss Trunchbull. I don't think that Matilda's that kind of child at all.
What is the school motto, Miss Honey?
Bambinatum est magitum.
Bambinatum est magitum. Children are maggots. In fact, it must have been her who put that stink bomb under my desk this morning. I'll have her for that. Thank you for suggesting it.
But I did it. Headmistress, Matilda Wormwood is a genius.
Nonsense! Haven't I just told you she's a gangster?
But she knows her times table.
Says she's learned a few tricks.
But she can read.
So can I.
I must have you know, Headmistress, that it is in my opinion that this little girl should be placed in the top form with the 11-year-olds.
What? But she is a squib, a shrimp, an unhatched tadpole. We cannot just place her in with the 11-year-olds. What kind of a society would that be? What about rules, honey? Rules!
I believe that Matilda Wormwood is an exception. To the rules.
An exception. In my school? Look, these trophies, see how my trophies gleam in the sunlight, see how they shine. What do you think it took to become English hammer throwing champion? 1969, do you think in that moment, when my big moment came, that I treated the rules with casual disdain? Well, as I stepped up to the circle, did I change my plan? What? As I dropped in my palms, did I wave my hands? I did not! As I started my spin, did I look at the view? Did I drift off my dream for a minute or two? Do you think I bothered when I ended my rotation? Do you think I altered my intended elevation? As the hammer took off, did I change my grunt from the grunt I had practiced for many a month? Not a jot, not a dot, did I spray from the blot? Not a detail of my throat was adjusted or forgotten. Not even when the hammer left my hand and sailed high up above the stands. Did I let myself go? No. Throw the hammer for your country. You have to stay inside the circle all the time. If you want to make the team, you don't use happiness or self-esteem. You just need to keep your feet inside the line. Sing, children! 2, 3, 4.
If you want to throw the hammer for your country,
stupid Russians!
No, don't tell me! We're not rich!
It's the mileage! They took one look at the mileage on the first car and said that these cars were knackered. I told them, I said the reason the mileage is so high is a manufacturing mistake.
Well, is that true?
Well, of course it's not true.
So you lied?
Of course I lied.
And they didn't believe you?
Of course they didn't believe me. I've got green hair.
I've got hair.
And what's this? Another blaming book? What's wrong with the telly?
She's got no respect, that one. It's all books and stories.
No, honestly, it's a lovely book.
Lovely.
You should read it.
Lovely. Here's what I think of your lovely.
No, it's from the library. It's library.
Stupid book to your stupid head.
Of your
What? An hour?
Oh, yes, you see. Unfortunately, Nigel suffers from the rare but chronic sleep disorder, narcolepsy. The condition is characterized by the sufferer experiencing bouts of chronic fatigue and falling suddenly asleep, often without knowing or any warning sign at all. You see, he fell asleep and we put him under the coats for safety, didn't we? Didn't we?
Yes!
He'll probably think he's in bed when he wakes up.
Is it time for school yet, Mum? Hey, this isn't my bedroom at all. Oh, why hello, Miss Trunchbull?
Amanda Fripp!
Yes, Miss Trunchbull?
What have I told you about wearing pigtails? I hate pigtails!
But my mother likes them. She says they make me look pretty.
Well, then your mother is a twit!
And
calculate this.
Fantastico!
Her mind is incredible. With a little help from us, she could.
Mind? Her mind? You really don't know anything, do you?
Somewhere along the way, my dear, you made an awful error. You oughtn't blame yourself now. Come along.
Little girl.
so the great day arrived. It was like the entire world had gathered to see the burning bird hurling through the air with dynamite in her hair, over sharks and spiky objects caught by the man locked in the cage. Everything was arranged by the acrobat sister, a frightening woman who used to be an Olympic class hammer thrower and who loved nothing more than to scare the children of the town. People whispered that in her dark and brooding heart, she resented her sister, both in her success and her love. Suddenly, out came the escapologist, dressed as usual in his tights and spangly costume, but there was no sign of the acrobat, and no glimpse at all of her shiny white scarf. And instead of the musical fanfare, there was silence as he solemnly strode into the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls,
the burning woman hurling through the air with dynamite in her hair, over sharks and spiky objects, caught by the man locked in the cage, has been... cancelled!
No!
Yes, the audience gasped so loud that a passing airplane caught on to its instrumentation and reported it as an atmospheric phenomenon.
Cancelled
because my wife is... pregnant. Absolute silence. You could have put a flyby. Then, suddenly, the audience jumped to its feet and roared in appreciation.
You may sit here while I teach the others, and if you have any questions, I shall do my best to answer them. How does that sound? Oh, Matilda, that is the biggest hug in the world! Oh, you're going to hunt the air right out of me!
Bruce, he might explode.
sometimes. Even me. Welcome, Bob Trotter. Good show. Well, come along, Bob Trotter.
What? Where?
How did I not mention? That was only the first part of your punishment. There's more. The second part. And the second part is choking!
No!
Do you think I will allow myself to be defeated by these maggots? Did you? Who do you think I am, Miss Honey? A weakling? An idiot? A fool? You?
But is he at all? He's gone much far. I need to decide, Dr. Trua. No, no, Mr. Trua, please let me be for you. No, Mr. Trua, please, no, please.
I would like to offer an apology for some of the things that have been going on here tonight. They are not nice things, and they are not right things. And I would like to state, guarantorically, that we do not want any children who might be here tonight watching this to go home and try these things out for themselves. I am, of course, talking about reading books. It is normal for kids to behave in this fashion. It stunts the brain, wears out the eyes, makes kids ugly, stinky, fatty, sweaty, betty, boring, gaseous, and crucially, it gives them verrucas of the mind. Under no circumstances do we condone such activities, and we do so utterly without reservoirs, blah, 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 blah. Can I just ask, how many people here tonight have ever read a book? Raise your hands. Anybody? You. Sir. What's your name?
Eric.
Well, Eric, don't take this the wrong way, but...
Bookworm, you stupid little bookworm, reading all these books like a stinky little bookworm. You read books like a worm. Worms read books. You read books. Worms are stupid. You're a worm.
That, Eric, we'll learn from that. Won't stop him reading, but he'll never raise his hand in a theater again. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you today the pinnacle of our achievements as a species, the very reason we bothered evolving out of unicorns in the first place. Someone on a show, I heard, that a picture tells a thousand words. So telling, if you bother to take a look, is the equivalent of like lots of books. All I know I learned from telling this big beautiful box of facts. If you know a thing already, babe, switch the channel over just like that. Endless joy and endless laughter. Folks living happily ever after. All you need to make you wise is 23 minutes plus advertising. Why would we waste our energy turning the pages 1, 2, 3 when we can sit comfortably on a lovely bumper leaf, watching people singing and talking and doing stuff? All I know I learned from telly. Bigger than telly. Smarter than man. You can tell from my big telly. Just how clever a man I am. Take it away, son. All I know I learned from telling what's a thing and what's a why. Now I was pretty smart already.
Now I'm really smart.
Very, very smart. Endless content, endless channels. Endless chat on endless panels. All you need to fill your muffin without having really big or nothing. Why would we waste our energy trying to work out Ulysses when we can sit happily on a lovely balcony? All I know I learned from telly. Bigger than telly, smarter than man. You can the better I am. Here we go. Who the dickens is Charles Dickens? Mary Shelley, she's so smelly. Surely protein, you do not want any. Jane Austen, in the old Boston. James Joyce doesn't sound very noisy. Ian McEwan, a good spirit. William Shakespeare, William Shakespeare. Moby Dick. Easy, Grandma. All together now! All I know, I learned from Sally. Come on! The bigger the telly, the smarter the man. You can tell from my good Sally what a very clever fellow I am! All right! Is it just me or my mate?
What? Well, we got to have a revenge section.
Why?
Oh, is there a child at school who's behaving like a bully?
No, not a child,
Matilda.
Exactly.
Are you sure something?
Well, Mrs. Phelps, would you like to hear the next part of the story?
Story? Did you say story? Did you? Suggest it.
Matilda, your parents must think they have won the lottery with a child like you.
so clever. I'm so very, 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 very clever. I'm so very, very clever. What a very clever fella I am. Never can stop me. Come here, you. I want my family to share of my triumph. What's your wife?
I'm a girl!
155 old bangers on my hands. All polished up, put the mileage on the clock, telling the truth. Each one was knackered. How could I possibly make the mileage go back? I couldn't very well drive each one backwards now, could I?
Backwards!
When suddenly I had the most genius idea in the world. I ran to the workshop. I grabbed the drill, and using my incredible mind, I attached the drill to the speedometer of the first car, turned it on, and whacked it into reverse.
Backwards!
Yes, boy. Backwards. Backwards, exactly. A drill's motor whirls backwards thousands of times a second. Within a few minutes, I had reduced the mileage on that old rust bucket to practically nothing. I did it to every single car. Backwards!
But stop talking now, darling. Yes, there's a good boy.
10 minutes later, the Russians show up. Bright, big, nasty face states, expensive suits, dark glasses, don't know who they thought they were.
Russians are nocturnal. I saw it on a program last night.
No, that was badgers. It was a program about badgers.
Same thing. And did it work?
You and you've cheated them.
What is the matter with you? What have they done to possibly deserve a child like you?
You know what I'm going to do tomorrow? I'm going to go down to that library and tell that old bag you're never to be let in again.
No, please,
and if she does, I'll have her fired. And you will never read another stinking book as long as you live. I'll put an end to your stories, young man. Now get in there and stay in there. You nasty little creep.
I shall spend the rest of my life making it up to you.
We shall be together forever.
I want.
There is an age for reading and an age for being a filthy little toad. These are toads. Archibald Trotter.
Yes, Miss Trunchbull.
Yes, Miss Trunchbull. Only Bald Trotter here is now a good toad. Sit. It has become clear to me, honey, that you have no idea what you are doing. You believe in kindness and bloodiness and books and stories. That is not teaching. To teach the child, you must first break the child. Quiet, you maggots!
But no one was speaking, Miss Trunchbull.
Miss Honey, please understand that when I say quiet, you maggots, you are entirely included in that statement. Where is my jug of water?
I'll get it, Miss Trunchbull.
Stupid girl. Look at you all. Blabby. Disgusting. Revolting, I say! I think it's time we toughened you all up with a little phys ed. This school of late has started reeking. Quiet, maggots, when I'm speaking! Reeking, they best disturbing scent. Only the finest lost smell it, but I know it all too well. It is the odor of rebellion. It's the bouquet of dissent. Anyway, that your riches, this headmistress finds this valedictorist as wholly olfactorily insulting. And so, to stop the stench's spread, I find a session on this air. Salts the merely land from the revolting. The smell of venom comes out from sweat. And this air will get you sweating. And it won't be long before I smell the fall of aiding and abetting. A bit of this head will tell us who has a handful of rebellious thoughts. Home, home! Just like a rotten egg flows to the top of a bucket of water. The smell of rebellion, the scent of rebellion, the horn of insubordination. In the bud, put it in two! Before the worm starts to turn, you must scrape off the dad and rip it from the mud. Now whip up the dad.
One, two, three, four,
and one,
two, three, four.
Three pubescent protest. The bomb of defiance.
One, two, three, four, one, two, three,
the bomb of anarchy in progress.
Please, please, please.
Once we've emphasized these demons, they shall be too proof for scheming. Some double time, discipline should stop the rot from setting in. All right, let's step it up. Double time. Ready, maggots?
Discipline.
Discipline, while listening for fidgets, while fidgeting or whispering in history, then chattering and chittering, then nattering and twittering is tempered with a smattering of discipline. We must begin insisting on rigidity and discipline, consistently resisting this anarchistic mischief. Minutes you are twittering, I'm pondering and pity. What little ones are missing out of discipline? The simmering and whimpering, the dribbling, the spittling, the tiny and cheesy, which is itchy, which is quick, and there's no mystery to mastering the elephant and mistressing is discipline, discipline. The smell of rebellion, the stench of rebellion, the ring of free, pubescent protest, the ring of resistance, the pawn of dissent, the funk of moral fiber of being.
the world with no children. Close your eyes and just dream. Imagine dawn trying it. Peace in the quiet of Abilene's dream. Now imagine a woods with a cottage. And inside that cottage we find a dwarf called Zeke, who can on a freak, who can fold paper hats with his mind. And he says, don't let them steal your horses. Don't let them throw them away. No, no, no. If you find your way through, they'll be waiting for you, singing. Papa sees a sticky dance. Have you ever seen anything more apparent? Have you ever felt anything more than the smell of rebellion? The stench of revolt. Loving of insubordination. Oh, if our resistance, the pong of dissent. And my blood stops till you are born.
Just once, and I'm sorry, I'm not quite explaining it.
just that still, sort of quiet. Like the sound of a page being turned in a book, or a pause in a walk in the woods.
Became my legal guardian. She was mean and cruel like you could hardly imagine. And then when I was presented with my job as a teacher, she presented me with a bill for looking after me all those years. She'd written down every tea bag, every electricity bill, every tin of beans. She made me sign a contract that said that I'd pay her back every penny. She even produced a document that said that my father had given her his entire house.
But did he really do that? Magnus, I mean, did he really just give her his entire house?
I don't know. But I find it very hard to believe. Just like I can't believe that he would have killed himself, which is what she said had happened.
You think she did it, man? Don't you,
honey? I can't say, Matilda. All I know is that years of being bullied by that woman made me pathetic. I was trapped.
And that's why you live here.
This roof keeps me dry when the rain falls. This door helps to keep the cold at bay. On this floor I can stand on my own two feet.
We don't have any evidence!
But we need- you just tell them? Tell them she did it.
That wouldn't work, Matilda. It'd be my word against hers, and they'd never believe that.
But why? She was so cruel to you. She shouted at you. She beat you. She locked you up in tiny cupboards and threw you in cellars.
Stop, Matilda, please.
Miss Honey, your aunt's a murderer. Who is she?
A contract is a contract is a contract.
Miss Trunchbull!
Peace.
B-U-F-T-Y-X-N. Big Fat Bully.
No.
P-Y-T-L-F-C-U-W.
Give Jenny back her house!
No! It
few days later, the acrobat and the escapologist's daughter received a letter from a solicitor. It said that she was now the owner of the beautiful old house. The house that, up until that very moment, had been owned by an evil aunt, one Agatha Trunchbull. The daughter moved in immediately, and she was very happy. Happier than she had been in her entire life.
As for Miss Trunchbull, she was never seen again. The trophies were immediately destroyed, and a new headmistress took over.
And her name was... Miss Honey! It was often said that her school was the best school in all the land.
Do you know something else? Matilda was never again able to move things with her eyes. I thought it was perhaps because she was being challenged, but she said it was because she no longer had a need for her superpowers. But sometimes I was looking at Matilda. This little girl who had done so much to help others, but who was stuck with parents who were mean and cruel and called her names, and I would feel my blood boil. And I wish I could just do something. So,
this is the end. God, I wish so badly that I could tell you that this story has a happy ending. I wish so badly that I could tell you that Matilda got the love that she deserved. But perhaps the truth is, not all stories have happy endings.
Don't stand there gawping. We're going to Spain.
Spain? But why?
Because this idiot, this Nick, this twittering, decided to sell 155 decimal fingers to the Russian mafia.
With a Russian mafia, did I? Come on, boy, we're leaving forever and we're never coming back.
Let Matilda stay here with me.
I beg your pardon.
Mr. Wormwood, I would love to look after Matilda. If she would like to stay with me, that is. Oh, I would look after her with love and care and respect, and I'd pay for everything. Would you like that, Matilda?
You mean leave our daughter here with you?
What did you say?
Did you call me your... They're gonna be here any minute. Dad, you called me your daughter.
They're here, you idiot, I told you!
No, quick, hide the books!
Oh, did they damage my legs? My beautiful legs!
You! You are the one who started this. Where is your father?
He's...
Your father is a very stupid man. And being stupid, he assumed that I was stupid too. Now that is a very, very stupid and rude thing to do.
Yes, I'm afraid my father is quite rude and very, very stupid.
You know this. At least there's one clever person in the family. What is your name?
Matilda.
How do I do, Matilda? You seem very smart. Sadly, in my line of business, I don't often get to meet smart people such as yourself. No, the people I meet, their thinking is all backwards.
Backwards!
Oh. Itatsa pukradis fire, mitatsa utsa.
Спасибо. Мне тоже понятно, поскольку мы стас ванны.
Ты говоришь по-русски?
Не так хорошо, как бы меня хотелось. Это красивый язык, я потому и стараюсь изучать его дальше.
Matilda, I thought you were to speak Russian.
I taught myself, I suppose. I was reading Dostoevsky, and I thought it would be better to read it in the language it was written in.
I am Sergei, and it's truly an honor to meet you, Matilda Wormwood. Come. Your father has been very stupid and rude to the all of us, yes? Good. So I can easily have one of my friends here teach him some manners. And then one day, when he eventually leaves the hospital, he'll still be stupid, but not as rude. I give this as a gift to you. What do you say? Matilda! Your scouser Matilda is so stiff in Stefania!
Asinice, that's fine.
Asinice.
Shut up. Your father is very, very stupid. But he is also very, 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 very lucky to have you as his daughter. Next time I'm in town, I'm on business. And I see you, you won't be as lucky.
Do you want to stay? Here, with Miss Honey.
Yes. Yes, I do.
You want to look after her?
I do.
Well, we are a bit short of room, so... Yes.
Thank you.
Because they had found each other.
Yes, they had found each other.